while the politicians seem to support the million-dollar industry of education and healthcare. There is absolutely no clarity about the Rafael deal involving high-profile businessmen, politicians, media houses from all over the world who have come together to shatter the Indian markets. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. Good morning, everyone. The few lines that I just recited were written by Rabindranath Tagore, showcasing his vision for India that he had post-independence. So now, the big question is, are we even this close to his vision? India 2020 was the term creatively coined by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Through this, he kindled a vision to ignite people's mind. Now, do you know why he did that? Yes, it is because he looked forward to a developed India across all horizons. So now again, the same question. Are we even this close to his vision? The answer to both my questions is a loud no. Now, before I talk about problems or proposed solutions from a common man's perspective, I'd like to share something. Of late, my parents really worry when I read the newspaper. They fear that I might question the system or forget that I might just run away from India someday, looking at its situation. Don't you think everything is so confusing? While the headlines of the newspaper keep roaring about the booming technology and cheap call rates, on the other hand, there is one little corner talking about human trafficking, domestic violence, and various other crimes against children and women of all ages. While the half-page advertisements boast about the giant corporates and the business sharks penetrating the Indian market, there is one little corner talking about the dying entrepreneurship and the fading zest of the youth. While the other page feeds our mind with extravagance and luxury, it seems that nobody cares to talk about the dying resources of water, our inability to fight natural calamities, and the expensive cost of living. While the politicians seem to support the million-dollar industry of education and healthcare, there is absolutely no clarity about the Rafael deal involving high-profile businessmen, politicians, media houses from all over the world who have come together to shatter the Indian markets. Now hold on, take a deep breath and ask yourself, are we really progressing? What is happening to our nation? In today's world, sportspersons have become actors. Actors, doctors and teachers have become businessmen. And businessmen have become fugitives. The entire economy has gone haywire. Knowing your rights and rising against the wrong takes courage. But what if the wrongdoers are politicians, highly influential or powerful people? In that case, who do we turn to? Now, these are just a few questions that my parents don't have an answer to. But I say, it's high time we take an action and get the real picture. Let not other mediums brainwash us, curtain our visions, or influence us. Remember, if we don't act, who will? The Constitution, the rules and regulations for the laws-abiding citizens require amendments today for a glorious tomorrow. In my opinion, there are only three solutions for this problem, which are knowledge, knowledge, and knowledge. Knowledge is power. Education is empowerment. With this one solution, we can make India the golden bird that it was once. A supreme power that nobody can shake of the global map. Now, I'd like to present my views on India 2020. Where terrorist incidents never materialize. Where soldiers, freedom fighters, and martyrs are always prized. Where wars, molestation and corruption gets erased. Patriotism is in blood, dreams and actions are at a pace. Where peace prevails and Satyamev Jayate is glorified. That is India 2020, my little heaven of pride. Thank you. So if you liked our video, smash that like button and don't forget to share, comment and subscribe.